destroy the enemy at its source.
Yes, sir. Wait. A planet which once sustained life, but the atmosphere seems to consist almost completely of carbon dioxide with some
hydrogen. Do you really think this is the appropriate time for a science class?
My apologies, but I feel as if I've seen this atmospheric composition ratio from Captain. I'm reading an ultra-high energy signal deep beneath the surface. It's unlike anything we've come across before. There's a high probability that this is true.
There must be a pattern. Extend the range of our radar and search the surface for leaking energy.
Understood. In the area ahead, there is a position of energy leaking from underground. I will deploy all riding ladders to that location.
Well done. Hear that, right? Looks like we'll have to head underground and destroy them directly. Set course to the objective point immediately.
Raiden has been successful in killing them.
Alright. The rest of the Raiden fighters and the Bellwether are important in the air. It will be disadvantageous to fight separately. Gather around the Bellwether and lend each other support.
CO2 at 95.32%. NO2 at 2.7%, argon at 1.6%, oxygen at 0.1%.
Syria, focus on the battle right now. You can investigate the atmospheric composition of the continent.
Yes, I'm sorry. But I have passed that combination to you before, and I think it's actually a chance of... With Earth's fate hanging in the balance, the enemy destruction rate is dangerously low. And his risers lack the action.
Are they in?
Affirmative. Raiden has reached the gate.
I'm glad that it's safe. Remember, folks, we're here to fight, not to get ourselves killed.
You know, it's one thing that civilization is progressing. But all these machines need your interface. Personally, I need a view of the ocean to realize it.
I got it. But remember now, Captain. CO2, a 95.32%, argon at 1.4%, oxygen 0.13%. It's Mars! This atmospheric composition is exactly the same as Mars!
The same as Mars? So? Although I fail to see exactly how that is important.
There is water on Earth, and not on Mars. That is said to be the reason why there is only life. There was water and there was not source. Why is there no water?
Who knows? I'm not a scientist, so I haven't got
to do it. What is this? If there was first water, then...
If for some reason life disappeared, the water disappeared and the oxygen disappeared from the atmosphere, are you saying that was caused by the physics?
I thought it was odd when you first noticed. Regardless of the contamination caused by the crystal, in order to destroy all life form on the planet, it would take 2 months. Yes, indeed. I see.
So what you're suggesting is that the crystals buried on Earth are not meant to contaminate the planet, but were buried to change the atmosphere itself.
What would be the crystal's motive for doing that? You mean to say they aren't trying to invade Earth?
What if the crystal spawns me for a first time battle in the past? Is the battle worthy of the crystal? understand you're nervous, but your response speed is lagging behind. Try a little harder.
Shiri, can you analyze the ingredients of the crystals that you found right?
I'll try. The crystals here are made mostly out of hydrogen and oxygen. In other words, they're close to dead water.
So what's being used here is different than the contaminated crystals after all.
If water is present, then more than half of the CO2 in the atmosphere will dissolve into water. There is a chance that the same thing that happened in the early stages of the ocean will occur here.
So, after turning the entire planet into an uninhabited planet of Mars, in time, we can transform it back into a planet where life can live.
So the crystals are trying to reset the planet?
It looks like this was more than a simple matter of a space invasion by an extraterrestrial life.
Can we bring to beings who act on a scale like this? These are beings who control planets.
That doesn't mean they can just give up. Besides, I've already planned my schedule for my vacation.
It's not good to analyze things more than is necessary. We're military. All we require to do is do our best in partnership.
Well, that's a whole impression to take things. A far outcry from our scientific discussion.
Are they the same civilization? Or a different civilization of crystals? Although I'm not totally sure about the concept of civilization.
That magnetic field surrounding Raiden is turning into something like a storm. This radar communication
is... Spock, what's going on?
We've lost communication. However, vitals still remain, so it is likely that the storm...
surrounding energy signals have all stopped. All enemies who had been engaged with Raiden fighters have stopped moving.
Could it be that they've really managed to succeed? Breathtaking.
Incoming transmission from Raiden. Mission complete. Returning to base.
All I can say is, well done. They really pulled it off.
Captain, hold on.
Nah, I'm all right. What happened to the crystals on the planet?
There is zero movement from the contaminated weapons. The crystals who had been eroding the surface have all collapsed like sand.
I see. I'm glad to hear that. I just hope this means that Earth is saved as well.
Earth is important too, but what were you thinking staying on the bridge after sustaining such a serious wound?
You're right. Valbarossa did a brilliant job giving commands, so there was no need for me here.
Well, you are the bloody captain of this vessel. As captain, you better bloody well do your best to give commands until we return to Earth.
I'm sorry. That might be a little too much to ask of me. Can I have a final cup of coffee?
I'll go make it. I'll be back right away, so hold on.
Drink a cup of coffee made by Asheria, who despises it so.
Don't say that it's the end. I'll make you coffee every day from now on.
I'm grateful for that. It smells quite delicious, but... Ah.
Captain, are you alright? Has your wound gotten worse?
Tastes horrible.
What? No, it doesn't. Why are you obsessing over such things when you're dying?
I agree completely. Although, I'm impressed that he'd go that far.
What is it? What are you trying to imply?
It tastes awful. How is it possible to make such god-awful coffee?
I agree completely, Asheria. You're abusing the coffee beans. There's no way I can die now. If that's gonna be the last cup of coffee I drink, I'll have you make it every day so that by the time we reach Earth, you'll be able to brew me a good cup.
Hey, I'm glad you're feeling better, but I don't want to make it for you every day.
Didn't you just say you'd make him coffee every day from now?
That... I did.
Asheria, look outside. It's the return of our heroes. I'm all right. So go and greet Ryan.
Yes, Captain. I will.